First of all, the Hindus have no difficulty in saying that we have actually come out of the single cell being like a bacteria. All of us, we started off as single cell being, I don't know, three or four billion years ago. And over time, we have progressed and become much more complex beings as human beings. The hardware we possess, the body we possess, has been chiseled by natural selection, like Darwin said. We agree with that. The environment will decide exactly what part of the body is suitable and continue to survive, otherwise they will get kicked out. So the body, physical body, is chiseled by natural selection. We are saying the software that kind of, in a way, inhabits the hardware is something that goes through reincarnation, comes through reincarnation. So we may have started as a single cell being, then we become more complex, then become a plant, perhaps an insect, an animal, and then become human. So we continue to evolve and take on, if you like, greater character, much more complex characteristics as we continue to evolve. There's nothing wrong with that. And the reason people say, why are such a huge amount of population now? There are now 7 billion human beings. Where did they come from? I'm saying from the animal kingdom. There's a huge amount of life trying to enter the animal, from the animal to the human kingdom. So we have no difficulty with this idea that human beings are extension of the living kingdom, including a single cell being. They are all living things. And again, the issue will arise when you talk of ahimsa. Suppose you go to, you know, some kind of infection, bacterial infection, and you say, ahimsa, there are million dancing bacteria in my lungs and I can't take their life, so I can't take antibiotic. See the problem? The serious moral problem. You are going to take life. Unfortunately, even the process of breathing takes life. When you breathe, you kill the bacteria that goes in your lungs, otherwise it'll kill you. So all the time, while I'm breathing and talking to you, I'm taking life. I'm actually stepping on another life. What should I do? Should I stop breathing? Well, I'm not going to do that. But this is, if you like, our limitation. It's if we are cursed to live off other things, living things, or perhaps destroy other living things. We are cursed, if it's the right language. So we have no problem about this idea of... But the important thing is this. Abrahamic tradition somehow feel that apart from human beings, all other living things don't have a soul. And there was a BBC program where they brought a little dog and said, do you think the dog has a soul? And the poor dog was wagging his tail. I said, of course, what do you think this is now? It's got a soul. It's got an individuality. And that is being visible in the animal form. So be it. So the Hindus, the Indic traditions are not difficult with the idea that all living things have a soul. The soul is very rudimentary at the bacterial level. There's hardly any individuality. It's kind of mixed, you know, kind of messed up. But then as it continues to evolve, it begins to develop individuality, a personality. And that personality then continues to prosper and take on more and more complex forms. So it's an ongoing process. But again, as far as modern science is concerned, this is a much more sensible way of looking at living things. Linking ourselves with the whole of the living kingdom, not just the human kingdom, saying animals are here for you to crunch and munch on. This goes against the Indic idea. We are out of the animal kingdom. They are very much part of us. So you must show respect. At least don't mistreat them. Don't be cruel to them. It comes naturally from the Indic traditions.
Free e-learning course in Hinduism. To register, please visit www.hindu-academy.com.
Talks on Hinduism, sponsored by People Care, encouraging caring for the elderly in their own homes. For more information, please visit peoplecare.com.